Welcome back to the Now Morning Show. We are having some groundbreaking conversations this morning, from just speaking to the minister. Now I have two wonderful ladies with me who are in the petroleum industry. Very exciting to have you both on the show this morning. We're going to be talking about a virtual career fair. I'm excited. So we have with us this morning, of course, the Vice President of El Dorado Offshore. Good morning. How are you doing today, Sirona?
Good morning, and thanks so much for having me. Good morning to your viewers as well.
Wonderful. Thank you for being with us. And we have the President of the Society of Petroleum Engineers, the student chapter, Ms. Pardesi. Good morning.
Good morning, and good morning to all your viewers.
And thanks so much for both of you to be on the show with us today. You know, as Kimberly said, it's Women's History Month. So we're celebrating all month long and having two lovely ladies with us who are in an industry that, to be honest, many say is male dominated. And I really would like to get to that too. But first, I know you're having a virtual career fair, and we really want to get to the meat of that and what made you decide now is the time to have a virtual career fair for your industry.
Yes, so thanks for that question. Basically, I feel that the pandemic, what we thought would happen 10 years into the future, have now happened 10 years forward, and it's forced us to act and pivot and adapt to situations where I feel like we can now use virtual forums to maximize our truest potential and to also reach a wider population and audience for what we want to achieve. The virtual career fair with El Dorado Offshore first started in Suriname, where we rolled out our first ever virtual career fair there last year, October. And UTT would have seen that and reached out to us to execute the same with them, which would be later this month, of course. And what we want to do is, of course, we are complying with COVID-19 restrictions and to ensure that it's a safe rollout. But we also want to ensure that we maximize our reach to so many students who want to learn and want to grow and interact with subject matter experts in the industry to realize that hope inside of them and get them the dream jobs that they seek.
Yeah, and it's definitely, I mean, a lot of people through society, you look at the petroleum industry and it's a fantastic industry to be in.
Definitely.
Now, you as a student, you're also the president of the student chapter at UTT. Tell me something, what made you decide, all right, I'm going to get into the petroleum industry?
For me, I have always, you know, growing up in Trinidad and seeing Petrotrin and the lights and everything, I was very intrigued by it. And the fact that it's, you know, a male-dominated field, though it is a male-dominated field, I still saw myself contributing and really making a difference in the field. So that's really how I decided to become a part of it.
I think both of you as women, you are making strides in the field as well. Now, Offshore Limited, El Dorado Offshore Limited is a part of this. What exactly does El Dorado Offshore do?
El Dorado Offshore is the leading manpower agency in the country. So we provide manpower supply and recruitment, personal logistics and catering services for clients in the energy sector. We have established entities in Trinidad, Guyana and Suriname. And my vision for this year is to really expand globally, where we can put Caribbean people to work on offshore platforms all over the world, not just in the region. So we pride ourselves on being that number one recruitment and manpower agency in the Caribbean.
Wow. And it's great. I mean, I'm going to say it again. It's great to hear a woman talk about it as well. And so, as you mentioned, we're having this virtual career fair. You're going to reach out to everybody. You mentioned, of course, again, that you're going to observe all COVID-19 protocols. So I just want to jump to our president here for a second. What was it like for you transitioning from school in person to going virtual, especially in this particular field?
For me, I would say it was a bit tough. As a student, you know, you are accustomed interacting with your peers, having that one-on-one with your lecturers, going to labs. But for the virtual, it gave us a little bit more flexibility. So I personally enjoyed having virtual classes. Though we miss going out on the field, it's still a good experience.
It sounds like a good experience, and it's nice that you have such a positive outlook on it as well, because, you know, so many people have been differently affected by it, and in this industry, you would say, as you said, you know, you go out into the field, so being able to adapt and have that flexibility is definitely something that you need, and of course, clearly you're flexible being the president of the society as well. So what exactly does the Society of Petroleum Engineers do?
So the Society of Petroleum Engineers, SPE, is actually the largest individual member organization that serves not only engineers and professionals, but also students as well. And the focal point is to collect, to exchange and disseminate technical knowledge in the industry, as well as to connect individuals to build their professional development as well.
So this collaboration now with El Dorado Offshore, what does it mean for the student chapter? Is this maybe the first, or is this something that we can look forward to seeing more of?
This is the first, and it won't be the last for sure. I think we will definitely be looking forward to collaborating with them more on it.
Sounds good. So in El Dorado Offshore, as you mentioned, this started off in Suriname. It's something that you're looking at taking globally. Are you also championing the cause, I say, well, I mean, I think you are championing the cause of women in the industry as well. And what has the experience been like for you?
Yeah, definitely. I stand on the shoulders of women who have come before me. Mm-hmm. And I'm happy to be, and lucky more so, to be in a position where I get to break the concept of glass ceilings. And what I mean by breaking the concept of glass ceilings is I feel that society sometimes places that glass ceiling there where people perceive it that we have to break that to break into the top positions in companies. But really the only limit that should be there for women is our imaginations, and anything mm-hmm. is possible once you have the right attitude and you have the right mentors around you.
Yeah, key. That's yeah. so important, having the right mentors. And of course, I think, well, I would like to say that this is what we're witnessing here with both of you. You mentoring, you having your being the president of the student chapter as well, yes. being able to push forward and, as you said, break those glass ceilings. And I agree with you. I think many times, you know, we create them, you know, and our imagination is key to being able to break through. So this virtual career fair is happening on the 26th of March, correct?
Correct, yes.
Okay, and where can we get more information about it?
So if you visit El Dorado Offshore social media pages, find us on Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, you would be able to register there. We are open to all persons in the country or even regionally who wish to participate and get to interact with subject matter experts on that day. Our social media pages will also have more information about who those subject matter experts are going to be on the day and what the workshops and so on are going to be presented throughout that virtual career fair.
So who is eligible to attend this career fair?
So mainly the target audience will be students, mm-hmm. graduates from the engineering faculties. But at El Dorado Offshore, we believe everyone deserves opportunities. So I don't want to limit it to just engineering students. We want to open it up to any student or any person who wants to learn more about the energy sector or who mm-hmm. has aspirations of becoming employed in the energy sector.
Yeah. So now I just want to come back to you for a second, of course, as a young woman coming up in the industry, working on this, well, I say working on this collaboration with El Dorado Offshore. Do you think this is the beginning of something for the student chapter that you're going to continue to push through and collaborate with other organizations?
Yes, I think it's something that we would continue to do, because as a student chapter, we want to create opportunities mm-hmm. for students to really bridge that gap from going from a student to a young professional and to assist them in the workforce.
Definitely. And Sirona, I know that's something obviously that you are doing, having this virtual career fair. So I do have a question for you. Where do you see women in the industry, let's say 5 to 10 years from now?
I see them championing their cause and in top positions. Actually, right now at El Dorado Offshore, in every entity we operate in, we have at least 10 women employed offshore mm-hmm. on the platforms and on the rigs. So they are championing their best potential and providing that inspiration for others to follow suit. So the same way that I stand on shoulders, I hope that one day they'll be able to stand on mine and do the same for others to come.
I love it. That's so beautiful. Best way to wrap, I have to say. For you, Ms. Pedersi, do you have any words of inspiration for younger women out there who are interested in getting into the industry but perhaps are not too sure how to navigate it?
Something I have always lived by since I started in the industry is to always follow your passion. If you're passionate about it, pursue it. It will never fail you. So that's my advice.
I couldn't agree with you more. So we've just had with us the president of the Society of Petroleum Engineering, the student chapter, Ms. Pardesi, and we have the vice president of El Dorado Offshore, Sirona Samru. Ladies, thank you so much for being with us on the Now Morning Show this morning and for sharing this virtual career fair. I really think it's going to make a difference, and you are breaking all the glass ceilings that there are in Trinidad and Tobago. This is the Now Morning Show. Remember that you can shout us out on Facebook as well, and make sure that you follow these two ladies, follow their accounts, and stay tuned because we're going to be back right after this.